Since last 1 week period, we have seen energy market was traded with a positive bias. Although crude oil is still trading in a very narrow range. Let's say in WTI, we are seeing prices is moving in a range of $40 to $44, whereas on domestic side, prices moved in a range of let's say 3,000 to 3,250. Still, we expect fundamentals are quite mixed. One side we have seen production cut or output cut from SAIL has been there. Inventory is dropping, that has been continuous supporting the prices. But on the other side, IEA has already warned that 97% of demand would be recovered by this year end only. That is just capping the gains. Overall, we expect prices is going to be trading in a very narrow range. Technical indicators are slightly sideways to positive as prices has consolidated in last couple of months. So this week will be more important. If we manage to hold about 30 to 40 on MCX, then there could be a small bounce towards 3,340, 3,380 level. That means on international market, a break of 4,350 can trigger the fresh buying to target of $45 to $46. But upside would be really limited only because again there is a concern of COVID in Europe and South Korea that can raise the second wave concern. And again, if there is a second wave concern, then definitely energy demand can again drop. So overall, I think market is going to be on a narrow range only. Only we have to watch is 30 to 40 level. A close about 30 to 40 can trigger fresh buying, targeting at least 3380 on higher side. Unless and until prices hold or below break below 3000 level mark, we may see this range bound trade for crude oil. Coming on natural gas prices, as we have suggested that due to supply concern, prices can go beyond 170-180 level. This week we have already achieved 184 level mark. Still fundamentally market is looking very strong. We can see a level like 195 to 200 also, but technically slightly overbought. Today inventory is going to be there, and inventory we are expecting that there will be a drop that would be supportive for natural gas prices, but due to technical reason we may see some pullback in the prices. So be cautious on natural gas. A break of a 185 can trigger fresh buying to the target of 195-198 level. Otherwise, prices may literally drop near to 170-172 level. From that level, we can again try to take a long position. Overall, medium to long term is going to be very much strong for natural gas prices. Since last 1 week period, we have seen greater volatility coming back in bullion market. We have seen overall in last 1 week period gold prices dropped by nearly 1.5% to trade near to 50 to 200 level on MCX, whereas in international we have seen prices move below $2,000 mark, right now trading near to 1940-45 level. Similarly, silver has dropped nearly more than 5%, and international also prices are just trading near to $27 mark. See, long term fundamentals are still supportive because concern of COVID, recession, ETF buying, all have been supportive for gold and silver for longer term transform. But overall we have seen that prices has rallied very sharply in last couple of months, so some correction is still needed to adjust this rally. So coming on gold first, in international, as we have breached now $2,000 mark, a break of 1920 can trigger further selling that can take support near to 1800-1820 in international. On domestic side also, we expect unless and until 54,000 doesn't break, prices can see support like 50,500 to 50,000 in next 1 week period. Whereas in silver, as compared to gold, silver seems to be more bullish because industrial demand has been now opening up after the unlockdowns are started. Holding below $30 can give us some pullback to the range of 25 as a first support, and we are expecting a drop towards $22 in next 1 week period. That means on domestic side, holding below 70,000 level mark, immediate target could be 64,000, but a break of 64 can further deteriorate the levels to the tune of 21 or 21 in international, whereas around 60-61 on domestic side. So overall, looking to the dollar index also, we have seen on daily chart there is a diversions showing that clearly show dollar index can regain to the tune of 94-94.20. So all this makes slightly vulnerable for bullion for coming 1 week period. We would prefer to take short position for very smaller we can say time frame. overall fundamentals still remain bullish only. During this week, we expect one should take short in gold around 52,500 with a stop loss of 53,200, targeting at least 51,000. Whereas silver can be shorted around, let's say, 68,000 nearby with a stop loss of 71,000. Target could be near to 62,000 in next 1 week period. Since last 1 week period, we have seen greater momentum in base metal prices. As week started, we have seen slight weakness in base metal prices. But looking to the fundamental, like China has injected more stimulus in the economy that has supported the prices. Some output cut, we can say, or we can say the output activity has been dropped because of that. Also, prices has got some support. On weekly performance side, if we talk, copper has gained nearly more than 4.5%. Zinc gained nearly 4.5%. Nickel gained nearly 4%. Whereas lead and aluminium gained nearly 1.5%. Dollar weakness has added some more support for base metal prices. Also, the lockdown in many economy has supported the copper prices, or we can say all base metal prices. But this is the time we should be more cautious, because this is not a fresh rally. In last 1 week period, we have seen a 4% rally. But if you see in last 3 month period, a tremendous rally of more than 10-12% has already been seen in all base metal prices. If we talk about YTD or 3 month rally, copper has rallied nearly 4%, whereas copper zinc rallied more than 11%. Or we can say after the deterioration we have seen in the month of March, prices has rallied very sharply, and now it's nearly on a new high or pre-COVID period, we can say. But slightly be cautious, because second round of COVID concern is started in the market. We have seen new cases in South Korea. We have seen some more lockdown in European market that can drag the prices again to the lower side. So I think technically market is slightly overbought. This week we can see some correction, particularly copper. Copper has already tested 530, 532 level mark, almost have made a high of 534 level. I think this is the time we have to be slightly cautious. We can see some profit booking in next 1 week period. Out of all commodity, I would be preferred to take short in copper around 532 level with a stop loss of 540. Target could be 510. Nickel failed this time to cross 1120 level mark. Unless and until 1120 doesn't break, a drop towards let's say 1060 could be possible. Similarly, talk about zinc prices. Already prices rallied very well to the tune of 196-195 level. Holding below 198 level can trigger some more profit booking to the tune of 185-186 level. So overall, in base metal prices, rallied has exhausted. Dollar index now started moving on a positive side. Diversion has been seen that could be negative for all base metal prices. So be cautious in any long position in base metal prices. Thank you.